Good evening, I'm Stefan Holt, and this is News 4 Now for Tuesday, February 25th. First up, we'll talk about the weather. More rain is on tap tonight. Tomorrow, looking grisly as well. Our high temperatures, though, they're going to hit the 40s. Turn out of the news and a dire warning from the CDC. They say an outbreak of the coronavirus in the U.S. is no longer a matter of if, but when. Currently, 57 Americans have gotten sick, and nearly all of them had either caught it on a cruise ship or while visiting China. No one in the tri-state has tested positive for coronavirus, but top health officials are now sounding the alarm, saying that an outbreak could cause significant disruptions to schools and businesses.
I had a conversation with my family over breakfast this morning, and I told my children that while I didn't think that they were at risk right now, we as a family need to be preparing for significant disruption of our lives.
For the second straight day, fears of the virus have wreaked havoc on Wall Street, the Dow dropping nearly 900 points. That's after yesterday's 1,000-point sell-off. It comes as outbreaks in Italy, South Korea, and Iran have all gotten worse. Worldwide, more than 80,000 people have come down with the Wuhan coronavirus. More than 2,700 have died. Here in Manhattan, Harvey Weinstein is not in a jail cell, but still in a hospital bed tonight, a day after being found guilty of sex crimes. Minutes after the verdict, he was taken to Bellevue Hospital with chest pains. His defense team says they don't know how long he's going to be there, but they vowed to appeal his conviction. The development's coming just as one of his main accusers in the case spoke out on the verdict.
I'm just very, very grateful that the jury showed that that they understand the reality of sexual assaults and sexual assault victims.
Police say they really need your help to find this guy. They say he's robbed five people in the Bushwick section of Brooklyn. In one case, he stuck a knife to a man's neck, and in another instance, he stabbed a man in the leg when he didn't hand over cash. Finally tonight, New York City subways and buses have a new boss. Sarah Feinberg has been named the interim president of New York City Transit. She's replacing Andy Byford, who resigned last month. Feinberg says her goal is to be honest and transparent with riders about the challenges the MTA faces and what it's going to take to address them. That's going to do it for News 4 Now. I'm Stefan Holt. Thanks for checking in.